forward come Crystal Palace with Owen Garvin. Lovely ball onto Zaha. He'll go for goal. Good save, Paddy Kelly. Looking to get behind their side. Davids with the back pass, so it's woefully short. It's Jamie Mackie. Will he be greedy? No, he will not. And Adelterapt strikes QPR into the lead after 4 minutes of the second half. But Jamie Mackie deserves all the credit. Edgar Davids has seen and done it all in his career. That's a moment he will want to forget. Mackie's been blistering in front of goal since joining QPR, but he did the right thing there. Adelterapt, QPR's captain, could not miss. The tabletoppers ahead. Into the 90th minute we go at Selhurst Park. Is there to be a final twist? Zaha hopes so. So do everybody involved in Crystal Palace. Oh, it's a great ball. It's the substitute, Kieran Cadogan. He's rescued a point in the London Derby for Palace. 20th. Blue and white hoops forward now. Goes a long ball. Helgeson has won it for QPR. The goal stands. Spironi is furious. He thinks he was pushed. Yellow carded for dissent. Heiner Helgeson has won the game for Queen's Park Rangers. And QPR's lead at the top, which was 6 points before today, will be at least that now. They've picked up another 3 points. I think Helgeson gets the ball. Neil Warnock is going to have a winning return to Selhurst Park. Late, late drama. But it's good late drama for them now.
Against top at Ashton Gate, Queen's Park Rangers are looking to set a new club record of 13 games unbeaten from the start of the season. Danny Rose in a bit of space to come forward. John Stead in support. Rose has continued his run, but Stead may go it alone here. And that's a wonderful finish by John Stead. And bottom club Bristol City lead the leaders QPR by a goal to nil. And what a goal from John Stead. Backs to the wall job now for Bristol City. Corner will be taken by Tommy Smith, the substitute. And the substitute Rob Hulse to aim at. Here it comes, Connolly with a flick on, and it's turned in by Patrick Agumang, I think it was, who got the final touch to Matt Connolly's header. And QPR have their equalising goal. 6 minutes from time. And it is indeed the former Bristol City player, Patrick Agumak, who started the year on loan here at Ashton Gate but failed to score in a temporary stint for City. He's come off the bench to score for Queen's Park Rangers here and may just have set a club record in the process. Simple finish in the end, right on the goal line. Neil Warnock's change pays dividends. Time is up here. The bottom club about to hold the leaders. They'll be disappointed it maybe wasn't more, but it's a club record for Neil Warnock. 13 games unbeaten from the start of the season.
The Queen's Park Rangers have gone 13 games unbeaten at the start of a season for the first time in their history, but a run of draws see them in danger of losing top spot. There's a big shout for a penalty there. Burnley bring the ball clear, undeterred. That's turned off by Iwaluma. Burnley have got a player over here. That's a good save, Paddy Kenny. Here's Rodriguez. Another good save by the goalkeeper. Twice Paddy Kenny called upon to keep out Burnley. Here come Rangers with Terapt. A little bit of space for him. Turned in a wonderful strike from Adel Terapt. Really has been the driving force behind this run at the start of the season. The only Football League side unbeaten still Queen's Park Rangers. and they take the lead. Long ball over the top, picks out Dumalumo. Marnie in the centre, bundled over by Connolly, and a penalty given. Clumsy challenge by Matt Connolly on Dean Marnie, for he does give a penalty. And it's Graham Alexander to score in the top corner. Missed his first penalty for the club last month, but no mistake this time. And Burnley a level.
After four successive draws, Queen's Park Rangers have been knocked off the top of the Championship. But they're still unbeaten this season. After 14 league matches, their best ever start in place of Reading side, who scored four goals in each of their last two games, beating both Burnley and Doncaster. Early opening for Rangers. This is Tourette. Will Adel Tourette tricked his way through past the couple of defenders, still going, and is brought down for a penalty. Brilliantly won by Adel Tourette. Reading just couldn't deal with the dazzling feet of the former Tottenham player, who steps up to score the penalty with an impudent, precise finish. And Queen's Park Rangers lead. Adel Tourette on target. The sixth time this season, but from the spot, 1-0 Rangers have the best defensive record in the Championship. 10 clean sheets this season, only 5 goals conceded. Come the 10 men, up to their total at the other end. It's pulled back towards Forlan, who makes it 2-0. Off the defender, Ian Harton in. And Queen's Park Rangers double their lead just past the hour mark. Forlan's goal, his first of the season. The space was for Tommy Smith initially, then it fell for Forlan, hit hard and went in. The kick brings the save from Federici, but the rebound falls for Tommy Smith, and Queen's Park Rangers have taken just 3 minutes to restore their 2-goal lead, and it's a first goal for the club for Tommy Smith. Former Portsmouth player is in the right place at the right time. Queen's Park Rangers return to winning ways against Reading and to the top of the Championship. They win by 3-1.
Decision referee. Liam Lawrence steps out, but he's kept out by Paddy Kenny at full stretch. But the referee has adjudged that Paddy Kenny moved off his line. And as the Irish goalkeeper was getting the congratulations from his teammates, the official says no, Lawrence will have another opportunity. Second time lucky, Portsmouth lead with 18 minutes to go, and the Championship League leaders, unbeaten this campaign, are behind in a fabulous atmosphere here at Fratton Park. Comes out to Smith. Such tension here in added on time. Smith, oh, does that hit the arm of Liam Lawrence? It does. It's another penalty. And right at the death, QPR might have saved this. Liam Lawrence gestures to where he thinks the ball hit. Despite the protest of his fellow teammates, Liam Lawrence might be in trouble here. He is, it's a second yellow. He can't believe it. Pompey down to 10. But that really doesn't matter in the scheme of things because QPR have a spot kick. Tommy Smith wins the penalty, takes it and saves QPR. It's a point for the Championship's top side. A dramatic finale here at Fratton Park.
The remaining unbeaten team in the Football League. Queen's Park Rangers have drawn 7 of their last 9 matches, which means they sit second in the table going into this one. Kyle Walker has done well to get away from his man, creates space for the cross. It's dropped by the goalkeeper and turned in by Rob Hulse. An absolute gift for his first goal for Queen's Park Rangers. Here for Tourette. He has support from Holtz. Goes in alone though, and in some style, the skipper doing what he does best. Adel Tourette makes it 2-0 for Queen's Park Rangers with his 7th goal of the season, and another real scorcher. It's becoming his trademark. 3 lone debutants in the side today. They're under pressure again. This is Tourette again. It's the same result. It's 3-0, it's 2 for Adel Tourette. Another from distance. It's 8 for the campaign now for the Queen's Park Rangers captain. It is certainly game over at Loftus Road with 6 minutes to go. Another really good strike.
showdown at Loftus Road between the Championship's two biggest hitters, Cardiff City, led by Jay Bothroyd and Craig Bellamy, come here in good spirits to win. We'll see them overtake Queen's Park Rangers. Stopping that man, Adil Tarapt, will be the key to winning. If Rangers win, they'll go 5 points clear of Dave Jones' side. 3 points for either would be massive. 13 minutes at Loftus Road. Bellamy on the prowl and Gawkes loses his footing. What a chance, Bothroyd to Craig Bellamy. Onside, Cardiff City lead. We are so dangerous going forward. Looking at clean sheet would be mighty impressive. It's not going to happen. It is Casper Gawkes. Cardiff's lead, in fact, lasted only 5 minutes. And the man who made the mistake for Cardiff's opener levels things up. You wouldn't know it. Neil Warnock's side have just scored. And how apt that it's Casper Gawkes. Tommy Smith did well. But that is a towering leap beyond Heaton. 1-1. Not yet had 18 minutes. This is going to be a corker. In goes the corner. Super pressure from QPR. Just over 20 minutes left. Ball is flipped off well to Adil Tarapt. A few stepovers, a glorious goal! The Magic Moroccan fires QPR into the lead. They could be going 5 points clear of Cardiff at the top of the Championship. Straight over to Keith Curl and Neil Warnock. He is a magnificent talent. This is why Adil Tarapt has lit up Loftus Road and QPR lead Cardiff. What can you say? It's outstanding. Mesmeric run. And the captain's done it for QPR once more. Massive points for QPR and Neil Warnock. They're 5 points clear at the top of the Championship. Dave Jones, Cardiff, took the lead through Craig Bellamy. But Casper Gawkes and Adil Tarapt mean Neil Warnock is celebrating along with the QPR faithful at the final whistle.
Queen's Park Rangers are just 90 minutes away from equaling a club record of 20 league matches unbeaten. That run from the start of the season means they're the last unbeaten side in the Championship. They're facing high-scoring Watford, though, tonight. Andrew Taylor. Slight deflection, perhaps, on the cross. It falls for Danny Graham. And Watford have the lead. Really strong spell, this, from the visitors. And it's flicked in by Jordan Mutch. It breaks here for Danny Graham. There is no offside flag. It's 3-0. Good ball into the middle. This was the intended target. Still not yet been cleared. It breaks for Tommy Smith. And Queen's Park Rangers have a goal back. All over. And so too is Queen's Park Rangers' unbeaten record this season.